Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. So I have been looking forward to this for a long time. I have gotten access to Krea.AI. I haven't got the real-time generation yet, but we have access to AI patterns. So I'm going to go over the real-time generation as well, show you some examples. I really think that this is a game changer and this can be used in a lot of different situations. But first, let's go over the AI patterns. I'm sure you have already seen some of these images, maybe on Reddit or different social media platforms. Now we can try it out for ourselves. So basically we have our prompt box where we can enter our prompt, and then we have some patterns that we can choose from, and based on the pattern you'll get a certain result that's similar to the pattern. So let's try it out. Let's go with the first one here and let's write the snow and the clouds. So it will take some seconds here. There we go. We got some beautiful results. And as you see here, they have mixed the pattern together with our prompt, the snow and the clouds. So this actually looks quite good. Depending on the pattern, you can do some crazy stuff here. Let's go with the windmill in the summer studio gameplay style. So I chose this one because it looks like a windmill, and I wrote the windmill in the summer studio Ghibli style. Let's hope we get something beautiful. Okay, yeah, these look good. So as you see here, it follows the same pattern. So I have seen some crazy use cases. Let's see if we can find some of them. So here's a beautiful example. You see a bunch of flowers, you see the sky, and then you have the grass and the yard. And as you can see, like, it does follow a certain pattern, and they have used Krea to create this. Here's another one. They have used a certain logo. You have the desert, you have the sky, some mountains. Here's another one using the same logo. And here we have some paradoxical structures and staircases. And we have this one here, front view, this one on the side. And here we have another one that says beyond the AI. I don't know if you can see it. And this one is with a text function. So here's another beautiful image. They have certainly used this here, preset number 16, to achieve that. Now let's get back to this here. Here we have another one of a big house. And here is a crazy building. It looks like the sun. One where it says sunny. Here's a beautiful example of a few monks waiting to be blessed, I guess, and they have used Krea to generate this image. It looks really good, except for the arm here, maybe this one here. It works really good with nature. So I have seen some examples of these and they tend to be the best ones. We got another one here. It looks like a butterfly, I guess, like you can distinguish the pattern. Now let's try some fun stuff here. Let's go to the advanced settings. We have pattern strength, so influence from pattern to the final image. And then we have the guidance scale. This is related to the prompt. So smaller values are more aesthetic and larger values obey the prompt more. So for this one, we can leave it as it is. And then we can even use some negative prompts. And negative prompts, if you don't already know by now, means that you can write the things that you don't want to show in the final image. So let's say that you want a field of flowers, but you can say no red flowers. So it makes sure that it doesn't show any red flowers in the final image. Here's some examples. They have written bad quality, low resolution image with artifacts. So yeah, if you write these, it will increase the chance of you not getting bad quality and so on. So let's use negative prompt and red flowers. Let's see here, and let's write a field of flowers in the style of watercolors. And there we go. You see, this is really, really beautiful. So it does follow the pattern, but down here you don't see it as much. This is because we reduced the pattern strength. We got another image here, and yeah, this one here is much more obvious, but it still looks really, really good. I like this image here. So yeah, you can play around with this however you want. You can decrease the guidance scale so it doesn't follow your prompt as much, but it makes something that fits much better. Increase this, you will get the opposite. It will follow your prompt as much as possible. So let's use the same prompt, but let's increase the guidance scale and let's remove red flowers from the negative prompt so that we get a few red flowers. And this is what we got. So now we can clearly see the pattern. We see the red flowers, and here's the other example. Now let's go with the same thing, but let's increase the pattern strength. This should give us some results that are obviously really similar to this pattern here. Yeah, there we go. I wrote a colorful cottage in the snow in the style of crayon painting, and this is the results that we got. We got this one here, and there we go. And it says here that we can even animate this. So if we click on animate, and let's see. So we got a subtle animation where it zooms in and out. Now let's try with the text here. Let's have snow, accept this here, and let's keep the same prompt. All right, we got two images. So this is the first one that we got, and I can clearly see the snow. We have the colorful cottage and everything else seems wonderful. But if you go to the second one here, it's not as obvious, but I can still see like the S-N-O-W. Here are some images of the chat logo, and as you see here, they have created some beautiful patterns with this logo. I can see this being hung on a wall. So the next one is the real-time generation. So I'm still waiting to get access to this one here, but I can show you a few use cases. So you have a window where you can paint, and then you'll get a generation based on what you're creating on the left side. As you see here on the left, this person has created a red eclipse, and then he's painting white underneath, and he has written red mushroom. So it does follow your creation and the prompt green frog on top of a red mushroom. And as you can see, you don't have to be that great. You can use it as a reference and it will create something that you want. He changes this to green frog with a red mushroom and adds a green circle on top. And then the system understands that this is where the green frog should be. And here's another use case. Like you see, this person isn't that good at drawing, but you'll get an awesome image here to the right. And the only thing that they have written is girl portrait. So you see here, it does a pretty awesome job, and I really believe that you can get consistent characters using this method, and you'll get a lot of different outputs and you can control it more effectively. So here's another one where this person is trying to create a product or a packaging for a product, and they just simply draw the outlines, and bam, you see here on the right, you'll get a product based on the painting. And yeah, you can insert circles and stuff like that and move it around, and you will get a generation in real time. You can be much more effective with this. Here's another fun one where they've written futuristic skyscraper complex Zaha Hadid, and as you see, they just draw a bunch of lines and you'll get a beautiful structure here on the right. So you can pretty much do anything you want with this. Here's another one where they try to generate a bunch of flowers, and as you see here on the left, they put in a lot of different images and they try to change the positions, and you'll always get a really beautiful image here on the right. So it's really fun to play around with, and the best part is you don't know where you will end up, but you will probably end up with something beautiful. And another fun thing here is that you can change the prompt in the meantime, so you can always change depending on what you think looks good or not. So in the process, you might learn some new stuff or you might try new approaches, and it's good. Here's another one. They have written Lego bricks cat, and they tried to paint a cat here on the left, and hopefully they'll get something that looks like a Lego on the right. Here's another one where somebody's using virtual reality and creating a scene, and on the right here we'll get new generations from Krea. You can do this with Photoshop, Unreal Engine or Unity and any other 3D program out there. I really look forward to getting my hands on this and try a bunch of different stuff. I really want to see if we can generate some consistent images using this method. And the last one here is somebody using it for magical architectures, as you can see. So depending on the camera angle and the perspective, you'll get different results. They have basically just created a bunch of boxes, and this is the awesome results that you get from that. So this one here makes me really look forward to get access to this tool. As you see here, they're just trying to paint something that looks like a cyberpunk warrior, and you'll get an amazing output here on the right. As you can see, like, this is pretty detailed still, but this isn't close to the image here on the right. And of course, we have the prompt down here, which helps us get the results that we want. So yeah, if you know somebody who works at Krea, let them know that I want to get access to this, and hopefully they can send me an invitation so that I can start to create some awesome stuff. All right, thank you guys, and see you on the next one. Bye.